Hello from Shraddha from Love Bites. I hope you all have subscribed and liked. I like a lot of likes. All the recipes are given in the comment box below. Please have a look. Today I'm doing a fusion food. I don't do fusion foods often, but today I was inspired. So it's a lasagna with spinach and paneer and a makhani gravy. It's quite popular at my place, and it's a good way to make sure your kids get lots of paneer and lots of spinach in the diet. Very easy to serve. Instead of doing lasagna sheets, I've done roll-ups, so you can do individual servings with these. And it's easy to do as usual. Have a look. Do enjoy. Bye. Let's start rolling. I'm doing a mix of Italian and Indian, like I told you. And let's go boil our lasagna sheets now, and then we'll start the prep. Some salt. Bit of oil. These are about 8 lasagna sheets. You can do them in batches or together. Boil them soft, but not overly soft, because then we won't be able to do the roll-ups. It's done. I'm going to drain it now and keep it aside. Run it under cold water. A tablespoon of olive oil. Once that gets hot, add in half a cup of chopped onions, and then we saute that till translucent. In about 5 minutes or so, add your ginger and garlic paste, 1 tablespoon. Now we need to cook it till the raw smell goes. I'm going to add in just a bit of salt so the garlic doesn't stick to the pan. So the rawness has gone. Teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon of coriander, 1 teaspoon of red chili powder. Just cook it for 2 minutes or so. This spinach, it's boiled and pureed spinach, 1 cup. I've just taken a little extra chop to give it a little better texture. Mix it well. Just let it cook for 1-2 minutes. 1/2 cup tomato puree. You can puree it at home or use canned. If you use canned, the color comes out well in this. Just cook it for some time. After we've cooked that a bit, we add in 1/2 teaspoon of mango powder, 1/2 teaspoon of garam masala, some salt. Don't add too much salt because there's a lot of cheese in this recipe. It'll get too salty. This is about 2 cups of crumpled paneer. I've made it at home. You can buy from the store or make it. Just crumble it and then add it to your the spinach gravy. Mix it well. It's very popular with kids because there's cheese and it's a mix of Italian, Indian. You can also get in a lot of spinach into the system and tomatoes and paneer. My guests have also really enjoyed it. Mixture is done. So the filling, that is. So we're going to keep this aside, and now we're going to work on the makhani, the sauce for it. Add 1 teaspoon of butter or oil. I'm taking butter because it's makhani type of gravy. Once that melts, add 1 tablespoon of ginger garlic paste. We're going to cook this till the raw smell goes. So I think it's cooked nicely. I can't get any raw smell. Around 450 grams of tomato puree. I've used the one in the Tetra pack because I want this rich color. Just cook this for like 5-6 minutes at least. Add 1 tablespoon of brown sugar, 1 teaspoon of kasuri methi, 1 tablespoon of Kashmiri lal mirch, salt to taste. Be careful with your salt. Again, I'm repeating, cheese will have salt. Mix it, and I'm adding about 2 to 3 tablespoons of cream. Remember, this is like a makhani, that's why cream is coming to it. I know y'all are thinking, oh my god, but yeah, we need it in this recipe. Increase the heat, just let it come to a boil so the cream doesn't curdle. Okay. Taste it. You feel you want to add anything else to enhance the flavor, add it, like a little more chili powder, salt. Do that and keep this aside, and then we'll assemble the lasagna, our paneer makhani lasagna. Let's start doing the filling. So take your lasagna sheet, cut it in half,
take your paneer masala, put it on the strips, just roll it. That's it. So make all your rolls and keep ready. Butter or oil your dish. Take the makhani, spread it a bit, not too much. And we're going to put the rolls in. Put your rolled up lasagna inside. Top it with the makhani, mozzarella. Be liberal with your cheese, okay? Grated and shaved parmesan. Now, you can add dollops of butter on top or oil before baking, but I'm not doing that. Here it goes at 190 degrees centigrade till it's a nice golden brown. It's taken 20 minutes. Let's get it out. It's done. Just be careful you don't burn the gravy. It's a beautiful color. And now we're going to eat it. So let's try this. It's heavenly. It's a really nice dish with the, you know, apna desi twist and Italian. You can call it lasagna, you can call it cannelloni, whatever you want. It's really nice. Do give it a try, guys. Bye.